It is still going, and honestly, I think all of our hearts go out to these crews here, right? You can't see them, but they're right behind this truck here. They've been here since 6 o'clock this morning working on that water main break, dealing with water and these cold temperatures. We can tell you that the water main has been repaired and water has been restored to the area, but the work does continue here tonight. The pond at Boston's Public Garden turned into a hockey rink tonight.
I'm looking at the weather app, and when you see the teams, you're like, prime pond hockey time.
These guys were out here for more than 3.5 hours and would not have it any other way.
Honestly, I'd rather be out here than in front of a fireplace. Like, this is so much more fun.
Freezing temperatures turning the water to ice, and several took advantage.
Best place in the summer is Fenway. Best place in the winter is right here. You got hockey, you got the beautiful skyline, it's nothing better.
The cold snap, not keeping people from their daily workout routines.
It's refreshing. You gotta do it, right? Or you just will go crazy stuck in the house, especially with COVID.
And while some were wanting to get out of the house, like this sweet girl.
She's been wanting to go out all day, and I'm clearly bundled up.
Others, like her owner, were looking forward to getting back inside.
Just taking her for a walk and then going back in, get a hot chocolate or something.
It was a rough day for Boston Water and Sewer, dealing with this water main break that flooded Milk and Broad Streets around 6 a.m. Crews dealing with the cold and wet for hours.
The cause of the break could be the temperature. All of a sudden, the sudden shift in well below freezing temperatures comes right away, may affect the pipe a little bit, the metal, and it may have caused the break.
So again, that water main has been repaired, but the road is still shut down here and will likely remain shut down through tomorrow until crews can work on repairing it. We're live in Boston tonight. Nathalie Pozo, WCVB News Center 5.
Nathalie, thank you.